Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and we are going to talk about BitTorrent Bleep today. And no, I'm not censoring myself. That's actually the name, BitTorrent Bleep. Look, well, I think BitTorrent, the peer-to-peer file sharing protocol, is most excellent, and I love BitTorrent Sync. It is my personal favorite free tool for automatically syncing files between computers and mobile devices. It's fast, and hey, no nasty centralized server that keeps track of my audio files or badly written poetry for the NSA. I gotta say, BitTorrent Bleep, kind of a stupid name. Or at least I thought it was till I stopped to think about the one thing in common across all the chat clients people in our office use. Some kind of weird ass noise that cries out for attention every time your dad sends you a naughty picture of Megan Fox, or your mom wants to know why you're not married, or your kid sister asks if she can have your socket set. Again. In any case, BitTorrent Bleep. Text or voice, full end-to-end encryption, no servers. That last one, the no servers part, is a big deal if you're getting paranoid about privacy in a world where the NSA gets to order companies to turn over info and order them to never tell you that they're turning over their info or spying. There's no log files, no metadata, no central database. It's just about the exact opposite of AIM, Skype, or Google's Hangouts, or the chat in Gmail. BitTorrent can't track you, your conversations, or even that they happen, because all the interesting stuff happens on the client installed in your Windows machine. Assuming, of course, the NSA doesn't force BitTorrent to put a backdoor in, but let's not think about that just yet. The client is super sparse. It's alpha. It's early. And that crazy umpteen letter and number combo there is from an incognito token from Michael. Sorry, Palmdalian, aka anonymous combo of letters and numbers, but I've exposed you. They can stay incognito. It's great for reporters and dissidents. Or give themselves a nickname so you know who the hell they are beyond 7BBC, 9EB, 7D, 60, 24, E9F, etc., etc. I left out like 24 letters and numbers there. You can text chat with the folks online or hit the phone icon in the upper right corner of the chat window to initiate a voice conversation with them. We found the voice call quality acceptable and the text chat was, well, chat-like.
Hi, Michael. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I'm so excited about our secret conversation.
You can import contacts from your address books, share your public key with your friends, delete your local history. So far, there's no way to initiate a group chat, but again, alpha, this is early software. So, Bleep, why the hell is the BitTorrent crew making a chat client anyhow? I'll get to that in a second, but first, buying razors sucks, right? Luckily, there's a company that's doing away with all the ridiculousness. For a few bucks a month, Dollar Shave Club is going to ship you amazing razors and other bathroom stuff right to your door. Their blades are just as good as the big shave companies. The price is tiny by comparison. Shave time, shave money. Join now at dollarshaveclub.com/techzilla. All right, so why is BitTorrent making a chat client? It's a good question. They've been working on it forever. BitTorrent loves privacy, and BitTorrent says it was a chance to apply distributed technology to conversations. Okay, that might be a new angle, their technology, but decentralized messaging apps are not exactly a new concept. Bleep sounds a lot like Project Iris, Waste, which popped out of Nullsoft in 2003, Rival, and there's even a BitTorrent sync-powered chat client experiment called Missive. Most of them are small projects, sparsely supported, and if I'm reading things correctly, a lot of them can leave tracks in somebody's computer somewhere. And that's where Bleep gets interesting. Bleep's product manager, Fareed Fadeh, stresses that BitTorrent has no access to the metadata anywhere in the pipeline, that you find your chat partner via nodes in the network, again, without the help of BitTorrent, and that all the links are encrypted. Not just the comms, but the links between the nodes, i.e. the Bleep client on your desktop to all the other Bleep clients, because none of this is tracked by BitTorrent. This is good. Fareed also stresses that we built Bleep as a consumer application. Okay, getting an umpteen dozen letter token, aka public key, that means I can Bleep with my buddy Michael is a little odd, but it's also because he decided to go incognito. Once you get over that sort of giant collection of letters and numbers, it's easy to grasp. Plus, phone numbers or email addresses can be used if you don't want to go anonymous when you configure your client. BitTorrent is also pushing Bleep as an engine that can serve as the back end to any chat and voice application, offering the potential to change how people all around the world communicate. So basically, the BitTorrent crew is kind of pissed about the NSA spying on everything, and they want to make it easier for other companies to, well, use their secure encrypted communications tool. So, a secure encrypted world online is actually way out in the future. Right now, Bleep is an invite-only pre-alpha. That means it's super early software and might crash for a Windows 7 and Windows 8 desktop users only. You can only use it on one device and you can't move it. But if you're curious to test out, do yourself a favor, head over to labs.bittorrent.com/experiment/bleep. You can trade your email address for an invite and then email techzilla@revision3 and we'll share our Bleep information with you. Want to learn more about keeping secure online? Check out the rest of our videos at techzilla.com or youtube.com/techzilla. I'm Patrick Norton, and thank you so much for watching this episode of Techzilla Bytes.